Pilgrims have begun arriving en masse to celebrate World Youth Day. Today, thousands of Christians converged on Brisbane CBD for the Brisbane leg of the Catholic event.
They came from all over the world, a sea of people marching through Brisbane proclaiming their faith, traffic ground to a halt. Earlier, they prayed together in both Catholic and Protestant churches.
Looking at the cathedral this morning, and they were hanging from the rafters, and I thought if we could do this every Sunday, how marvellous it would be.
The Catholic Church's first World Youth Day was 22 years ago. This is the first time it's come to Australia, and Brisbane was keen to play a part before the main event in Sydney next week.
So it's our chance to have our own sort of World Youth Day event in our own backyard.
I think this is one of the way that things meet other people from other lands.
We've been preparing for 2 years and doing fundraisers, and getting able to do this is amazing.
Organisers say up to 15,000 people converged on the Roma Street parklands.
It's amazing. It's the biggest thing I've ever seen in Brisbane, and certainly the biggest thing for the Catholic Church here for a long time.
Most of these people will spend 4 days in and around Brisbane. In that time, it's expected they'll inject as much as $9.5 million into the local economy.
Many of the faithful will continue their pilgrimage to Sydney tomorrow. Christina Harrison, ABC News.
Many pilgrims are already in Sydney, gathering to pray and to party. And the man they've come to see is on his way. The Pope is due to touch down in Australia tomorrow.
Melbourne loves to trump Sydney, and so last night it was the first city to stage a mass on a massive scale. 30,000 Catholic faithful packed the Docklands Stadium. Sydney is still warming up, but at Kingsford Smith Airport, Catholics had no trouble finding friends. The arrival lounge looked more like the opening ceremony of the Olympics, as pilgrims wore their nationality on their sleeves and on their heads.
Too much Pope is not enough?
No, never enough.
2 days of flying is now a distant memory.
It doesn't matter with the jet lag.
World Youth Day ambassador Sophie D'Alesio will get to meet the Pope. She painted the first section of the festival's mural. She says her message for Benedict XVI will be simple.
Pray for all the sick kids in hospital.
Knights and knaves from the Order of Malta will help pilgrims with disabilities. The religious group was founded in 1099 during the Crusades.
It's been the work of the order through those centuries, as I say, to care for the ill, to care for our masters the sick, our masters the poor.
The pilgrims are not getting a warm welcome from Sydney. Many from the South Pacific are shivering under the winter chill. To help out, the Fijian community is donating blankets and jumpers. And if that doesn't warm them up, there's always kava to put fire in their bellies. David Spicer, ABC News, Sydney.
Every nation, every tribe, come together to worship you. In your presence we delight, and we will follow to the ends of the earth.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
receive the power from the Holy Spirit.